3 gram of urea, NH2CO, NH2 dissolved in 45 gram of water, the relative lowering in vapor pressure. So this is the solution of urea dissolved in water. Urea is the solute, water is the solvent. Mass of urea and water given. So 3 gram of urea, that is the mass of the solute W2. 45 gram of water, mass of the solvent W1. And we need to calculate the relative lowering in vapor pressure. We know the equation, relative lowering in a vapor pressure, P10 minus P1 divided by P10. This is equal to X2. X2 is the mole fraction of the solute. X2 can be written as, it is the ratio, mole fraction is the ratio of number of moles of the solute to the total number of moles of solute and solvent, N1 plus N2. And for dilute solution, this N2 in the denominator can be neglected. So that the equation becomes N2 divided by N1. We know the number of moles. Number of moles is equal to given mass by molar mass. So number of moles of solute N2 can be written as W2, mass of the solute, divided by molar mass of the solute, M2, divided by N1. What is N1? W1, mass of the solvent, divided by molar mass of the solvent. Substituting the values here, W2 is 3 gram. Mass of solute 3 gram divided by molar mass of urea, we can calculate from the atomic masses. The sum of the atomic masses will give you the molar mass of urea, that is 60, divided by W1. W1 is 45 gram mass of solvent, divided by molar mass of water, we know 18. So we get the equation 3 by 60 into 18 by 45. We take the reciprocal of the denominator. So what do we get here? If you cancel 3 and 45, how many times? 1 time 15. 15 and 18 we can cancel by 3, so that we get a 6 here, 5. 6 and 60, 10. So that we get 1 by 15. 1 by 50 is equal to 0.02. So this is the relative lowering of vapor pressure. Option B is the right answer. Now, next question, question number 2. The freezing point of an aqua solution is given. That is, if the values of Kb and Kf are also given, elevation of boiling point of the solution you need to calculate. Freezing point is given means this is the TF, that is freezing point of the solution. TF is given, Kb and Kf values are given, and we need to calculate the elevation of boiling point of the solution, that is delta TB. We need to calculate. We know the equation, delta TB is equal to Kb into molality. But the molality of the solution not given in the question. Instead, what is given? TF is given. If TF is given, we can calculate delta TF, right? Delta TF is equal to KF into molality. So from this equation, molality will be equal to delta TF divided by KF. Delta TF can be written as TF0, freezing point of the pure solvent, minus TF by KF. Freezing point of the pure solvent in degree Celsius, we can write 0 degree Celsius, minus TF. TF value given in the question, negative 0.186, divided by KF value. KF value is given in the question as 1.86. So here we get 0.186 divided by 1.86. On solving this one, multiply by 100. On denominator and numerator, what do we get? We get 18.6 divided by 186. The answer is 0.1. So we got molality here. This is molality. So substitute the molality here and Kb. Kb is given in the question, 0.52 into molality 0.1. The answer is 0.052. degree Celsius or Kelvin. This is the right answer, option D. Now the third question, what happens when blood cells are placed in pure water? We know osmosis takes place, flow of water takes place from the higher concentration region to lower concentration region, higher water concentration region. In pure water, the water concentration will be greater in pure water. So water flows into the blood cell. So the answer is option B. The water molecules rapidly moves into the blood cell. The solvent concentration is more in pure water than in blood cell. So water flows into the blood cell. So option B is the correct answer. During osmosis, flow of water through a semi-permeable membrane is from both sides of semi-permeable membrane with equal flow rate. That's not correct. From both sides of semi-permeable membrane with the unequal flow rate. From solution having lower concentration, from solution having higher concentration. So the answer is the from solution having lower concentration. Lower concentration solution means solvent concentration will be, concentration of solution means it is the amount of solute. Lower concentration of solute in the solution means solvent concentration is higher. So from solution having lower concentration of the solute or solution having higher solvent concentration, osmosis takes place. So option C is the correct answer. Now the last question, at high altitude boiling point of water decreases. High altitude the atmospheric pressure is low. This is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer.